YouTube search for
Promise Federation.
Watch on your big screen.
Or another device if you're at home.
Get yourself comfy, this could take a while. What a happy scene. Something new every day for your long-term memory. This is so exciting, it is nearly time for a
forest
assembly. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, or good night, everybody, and welcome to our Forest Federation Monday welcome. Welcome, children and staff from Newton. Welcome, children and staff from Stukeley. And welcome, families from everywhere. It's great to be back. I hope you had a good weekend. Weather not too bad where I was, so hopefully you had the same. Plenty of sunshine, a little bit of rain, but do you know what? We can work with that. Things to look forward to this week. Let's do it. Okay, last week was incredibly busy. I can't promise as much going on, but that's probably a good thing. We have got forest school happening for most children at Stukeley and some children at Newton this week. We've also got a sharing assembly for Newton on Thursday, and we're inviting an in-class families, foundation and year one families to that. It's gonna be fantastic and we can't wait for it. Also this week, we've got some year sixes going to a football festival from Stukeley. Got that to look forward to. Lots of clubs and other bits and bobs going on. If you want to join anything or want more information about those clubs, let the school officers know. And also this week, very exciting, we've got the first results from our Forest Federation Prediction League. Did you or your family take part? Are you a member of staff and did you take part? How many points did you get? Mrs. Wing from Stukeley will be giving out all of that information this week. And don't forget to get your sheets for the next round. It's coming up thick and fast. Gonna be great. Right, let's talk about this week's curriculum. Okay, I'm going to talk about the Newton curriculum first. I'm then going to talk about Stukeley. You can fast forward any bits you want to. Remember, if you're listening to something which isn't your year group, it isn't your class, still listen in, because you've either got it to look forward to or you remember it from last time. And that's great for the memory, this is right, Newton. And in class, this week you're still on Red Riding Hood, you're beginning to use dialogue and speech in your sentence stacking, lots and lots of talking in that story, you're using number lines to compare numbers in your maths, are they greater or less than, who knows, in computing you're looking at being safe using Purple Mash, in science you're looking at the five senses, I wonder if you know what they are, and in your RE you're looking at how Diwali is celebrated. And I think you might tell us about that in assembly too. Good old class, you're carrying on with your star in the jar work. You're finding powerful adjectives to describe what's done, what sounds are like, and what the feelings are. So loads of really good vocabulary work going on. In maths, all year groups are finishing off place value and showing what you've learned. And we're gonna be making a start on the next steps in addition. Lots going on in our maths, good old. We're looking at the main beliefs in Islam in our RE sessions over the next few weeks. And you're starting to look at the Bronze Age in history. Had a bit of that Stukeley as well, lots of good links. And then you're looking at rainbow foods in your DT. That's after your brilliant assembly last week, good old. You've got Forest School this week as well. Einstein, you're finishing off your independent writing and your editing. Getting your best better this week, Einstein. Year fives, you're looking at rounding, inverse operations and word problems in your maths. Year sixes, you're looking at prime, square and cube numbers. Ah, loads going on. In your history, you're learning about the wheelchair warriors' fight for rights. That sounds interesting. In your science, you're looking at what happens to the body during exercise. And in your DT, you're carrying on with your bridge learning, but now you're going to design your own after some of the disasters of last week. I know all about them. Yes, I do. Stukely, brilliant. Foundation stage, you're starting on your sounds, your first phonemes, you're working really hard to hear them, to say them, and at some point you'll think about starting to write them down as well. But at the moment there's loads of hearing sounds, trying to work out different sounds from others, trying to distinguish sounds. You're also working really hard on your pencil grip, holding your pencil, thinking about writing your names as well, foundation stage. Year one, you're writing story sentences from Where's My Teddy? You're looking at addition and subtraction within 10 in your maths. In RE, you're looking at features of Jewish worship, and in history, you're looking at what Tudor houses were like. Lots and lots of interesting differences there from what we have now. In your science, you are trying to describe materials. Now, I remember year ones last year, loads of brilliant vocabulary, loads of new words coming in. Let's do the same this year. Year two, you're writing your own Traction Man stories this week. I know how much you enjoyed it. Let's get your own versions out. In your maths, you're starting addition and subtraction, starting with number bonds to 10. How many ways to make 10? 9 and 1, 8 and 2, 7 and 3. I know them, and you need to know them as well. In your history, you're learning about how food has changed over time. Looking at lots and lots of work on that this week. And in your RSE, you're learning about well-being and talking about our feelings and how they might affect other people. Oh, in science, you're testing absorbency. Oh, come on, brilliant. Year three, you are writing holiday brochures for Skara Brae in your English this week. Probably a bit of persuasion there. Year four, doing the same. You're adding across tens in your maths. Lots of really good concentration needed there. You're talking about where fossils are found and what we know about them in your science. You're carrying on your Stonehenge learning in history, filling your brains, filling your memories with knowledge about that. And in computing, you're talking about how information travels across the internet. The internet's incredible. Let's learn more about it. Year four. Goodness me, I've turned over yours, year four. Sorry. What good skills. Year four. You are adding and subtraction. You're adding and subtracting up to 4 digits in your maths. Big numbers going on there. In English, you're starting to think about persuasion. You're going to be writing a letter this week. Come on, make the difference. In your history, you're carrying on your Romans learning. What did the Romans tell us that we still do today? In your science, you're carrying on your electrical work on circuits. I know how much you're enjoying this, apart from when the batteries have no power, right? Keep that going. And then in your art, you're imitating the work of L.S. Lowry. And in French, you're looking at the verb to be. Yes, you are. Year fives, you are looking at Maya Angelou's poetry this week with Still I Rise. You're looking at the shape of the poem, and you're learning about the poet herself. You're looking at multi-step addition and subtraction. You're comparing calculations. You're finding Mrs. Numbers. I spoke to Mrs. Daly this week about maths. I think most year fives are really on it, but you have to concentrate right to the end with your maths, because silly mistakes mean wrong answers, and we can avoid them, I promise we can. In science, you're looking at the life cycles of animals, you're comparing them and looking for similarities and differences. In your history, what did the ancient Greeks believe? Bit of Greek mythology there, all about the Greek gods. And in PSHE, we're learning about the importance of goal setting. Why do we set goals? Why would we put ourselves through it? You're going to find out this week. Finally, year six, you are looking at biographies. Who's Jane Goodall? Who is she? There's a class at the Newton called Goodall class. Might be a brilliant link here, year six. We'll see. In maths, you're looking at different methods of division and your introduction to long division. Ah, my head hurts. History, you're looking at the key features of the Industrial Revolution. You're talking about crime, which is always interesting. You're talking about pollution, which, yeah, depressing but true. Oak class, in your science, you're looking at nutrients being transported around the body. And in sycamore, you're looking at how living things have adapted to their environments. And to finish up, in your computing, you're looking at analysis and evaluation of data. Man alive. That is a lot of stuff going on, but I love to hear how busy we are. Thank you all for listening in. Let's crack on with home learning.
Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. This is a home learning. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. This is a home learning.
Okay, everyone, I'm hoping, my fingers are crossed, I'm hoping that you've, all of you that need them, have got your learning logs. I'm sorry they're not the real ones. They are interim ones. They are kind of practice ones until the real ones come through. You know what the deal is. You should be reading 5 times a week to yourself or to an adult. You need to write 5 sentences a week. If you are one of our younger children, the adult might do it for you. 5 sentences about what you've read. That's reading and writing. Quizzing, AR quizzing if you're on AR books in Newton or Stukeley, and you can write which books you've quizzed on in your learning log. Spellings or phonics should be coming home. Give them a practice each week, please. And then we've got Numbots and Rockstars. If you've got any questions about those, please talk to your teachers and they will answer. Right. Creative challenge last week. I mean, it was all about the number 10, right? Yeah. I don't think we're getting much at all from Newton. This creative challenge is open for everyone. So when we get to the end of this video, Newton children and Stukeley children, look to see what the challenge is, because you're going to like it.
Walking in the rain and the snow when there's nowhere to go, when you're feeling like a part of you is dying and you're looking for the answer in her eyes. You think you're gonna break up, then she says she wants to make up. Walking in the rain and the snow when there's nowhere to go, when you're feeling like a part of you is dying.
Oh, I tell you what, Mrs. Page, can I send a picture of me in? I mean, that would count, right? Yeah? Okay, everything beginning with S. Fill up your image, send them in to Mrs. Page. It's going to be brilliant. Right. Let's finish off this Monday welcome, this crazy busy assembly, with birthdays.
Hey, 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 it's time to say, let's celebrate a birthday. Hey, 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 it's time to say, let's celebrate a birthday.
Come on! Ha-ha! Another week of birthdays. Who are we celebrating this week? Well, today we're celebrating Ryan from Newton Primary School. He's in year 4. Happy birthday, Ryan, for today. We're also this week celebrating Amelia from Stukeley, year 5. George from Stukeley, year 5. Arwen from Stukeley, year 5. What a week for year 5s. Nifemi from Stukeley, year 2. Sierra from Foundation Stage at Stukeley. And Kira from Newton, who's in year 2. Happy birthday to all of you for this week. Lots of fun coming up. I hope you enjoy every single moment. Birthdays are still great when you're an adult, but they just feel a bit more special when you're a child. Right, finishing up, what's next? Well, we've got some Cheer Boo Song or Silencers coming up this week. Keep an eye out for them, the big return. Also, Newton, I've got a music video coming out for you. A little celebration of what happened with Mrs. Nightingale last week. And straight after this video, we've got a get in and we've got an EDK. If you are a footballer, if you like playing football, if you play at the weekends, if you play for a team or a club, even if you don't like football, this is a great get in challenge. I'm expecting to see some spectacular get in videos this week. Don't let me down. Have a great week.